It's like a GPS, but with way better music. The Backseat Drive with Shadow Davis on 92 City FM.
I feel good. That's like somebody else on YouTube. There's a comment that says, "Nice try, but this sounds a lot like Adam Sandler. Try being original." It's like,
that's kind of the point. I'm going for.
What I'm going for. It's an impersonation.
Okay, yeah, that's it. Oh, here we go. 92 City FM, Winnipeg's original rock station. There's Harlequin and the Sweet Things in Life on a double shot weekend. Also, U2, Beautiful Day, two from Robert Plant, one with Zepp, one with we heard Tall Cool, one and Ramble On. 318 at Shadow Davis. The special treat that I was talking about 10 minutes ago is Rob Nash. He's a local recording artist and inspirational speaker. You may have seen him on YouTube in the last couple of days. When did you put that video up?
Honestly, wrote the song not yesterday morning, the morning before, and by the evening we posted, yes, my Adam Sandler rendition, and I didn't really expect this to happen.
Well, you know what? 6,101 hits so far in less than 48 hours.
It's not obvious, bad, eh?
Well, it's pretty good. Let's hear it for Rob, by the way. Yeah. Before we get, now this is Adam Sandler doing Winnipeg Jets. This is you doing Adam Sandler doing Winnipeg Jets to the tune of the Hanukkah song.
Exactly. Yeah, you know what? I woke up and I was thinking, you know, everybody's talking about the Jets. Everyone's excited. But there's some people, the young people, may not even remember. So I was like, I should write a goof song. You know, a lot of my songs are pretty serious. But I was like, I should write a goof song. And I'm like, I'll do it in the form of Adam Sandler. I love doing voices. I get really bored on the road, so I do impersonations all the time.
Now, wait a minute. Besides Adam Sandler, who else do you do?
Well, you tell me. Okay, ready? Well, no. Okay, have you seen Lord of the Rings?
Yes.
Okay, you know Gollum?
Of course.
I found this one out by accident. Check this. No, Smeagol. Master's a friend. Give it to expression wiggling.
That sounds like three people.
Right?
It sounds like
and then,
three well, voices.
It gets worse, though, because you know Shaggy, the rapper?
I thought you were talking about the Scooby-Doo.
You know Shaggy, the rapper. All the girls think he's got like a hot voice. I'm pretty sure it's the same dude. As Gollum, because Gollum's like, "No, Smeagol," and Shaggy's like, "It wasn't me."
Inspirational speaking. Who do you speak to? You speak to kids? What do you speak to them about?
Well, I was in a major car accident a few years ago, actually found dead on arrival, and I wanted to use music to inspire people, and we had a couple top 10 hits in Canada with my band and stuff, and then we all had an opportunity to walk away from the record deal, take my acoustic guitar, Johnny Cash style, and go through schools, prisons, youth detention centers, and speak to over 700,000 students. And everybody thought I was a lunatic walking away from a record deal and all the big tours and stuff, but that's what I was waiting to do, something like that. So that's how it started, going into schools, high schools, junior highs, and then it just continued to escalate and grow to where the point now where we go into youth detention centers and prisons and stuff, and we write songs together with students that have, like, murdered their parents, you know? Like, and it's very therapeutic, so we'll write songs of suicide, of addictions, and different things that they deal with.
Yeah.
And then we take those songs, we teach them drums, guitar, we design CD covers with them, and we make a project with them, and we go around doing that, and then we take those same songs, and we record them. And if you go to our website, which is robnash.com, and I spell Rob with two B's, the videos that pop up, one of the main producers, a three-time Emmy-nominated producer out of Hollywood, saw me speak at a youth detention center in Vancouver, and he says, "I'm leaving what I'm doing in Hollywood. I want to film what you do for free. I just think it's fantastic." So if you go to our website, all those videos that pop up, that guy did the videos, and our old producers, like our record producers that we had when we had our record deal, same thing. They said, "We don't care that you don't have a record deal. We want to record these songs with you." So we actually just launched our new album on iTunes just like 3 weeks ago. And it's all just, our team is building with people that just want to be a part of something with purpose. So.
That's amazing. And, you know, I didn't know any of this stuff until this morning when I hit your website because I had seen your YouTube video for that one goof song. So a lot of attention is being paid you for this song, but really, you do a lot of good work.
Well, yeah, that's why it was kind of goofy. Cause, like, even when we're in the schools, I don't want to talk about, if we do an hour show in the school, I don't want to talk about suicide for an hour because everybody's going to want to kill themselves.
But well, you got to lighten things up.
So I'll break into like an Adam Sandler or some of my other stupid voices, or I'll sing a Lady Gaga song just to goof on her. But so I'll break it into humor. But I really didn't think this was the way it was going to get all this attention.
Well,
but like you said, like you read in the Sun today and it's like, same thing. The Winnipeg Sun called and they said, "Wow, look, you know, we thought this was a funny story. Then we went to your website and say, oh, you're doing some cool stuff."
Yeah.
So, yeah, It's pretty interesting how this is coming about.
Well, that's great work you do, man, and you should check it out. It's robnash.com, two B's, R-O-B-B-Nash.com, to find out what Rob does, and maybe you could get, you know, some... I don't even know if you call it work, because you don't get paid for that, do you?
Well, no, but, and it, honestly, schools don't have budgets for that. Like, we just got a call from Brampton, Ontario, and they said, hey, we just had a suicide in our school. Can you come talk to the kids? I don't want to go like, well, our flights cost this, and our hotels are this, so we just say, yeah, we'll be there next week, you know.
So how do you do that?
We just, honestly, it's been a bunch of people that have seen what we do, that have believed in it, and see the effect that it has on kids, and it sponsor us. I just had a guy on a flight a little while ago sponsor several shows.
Well, maybe you could make a recording of this song and sell it to charity. That'd be awesome. I think that'd be a great
idea. Bam!
Just saying. Just saying. Okay, everybody wants to hear the song. What do you call the thing? Welcome Back, Jets?
Sure.
Okay.
Shadow just named my song.
Welcome Back, Winnipeg Jets. Here's Rob Nash.
Well, there's a lot of songs out there that are written for all kinds of different sports teams, but... Not too many songs for the Jets, so I wrote this one here. Here we go. When you feel like the only kid in town who doesn't remember Winnipeg Jets have on, here's a list of people who played for us back before 1997. Timo Salani scored the most rookie goals. Thomas Steen once had to drive a crappy road. Dave Babbage once called Winnipeg his home, and even Eddie Olchuk had an MTS phone. Other teams brag cause they had Gretzky, but not Winnipeg, we had Ty Domi. Put on your jersey, it's time for NHL hockey. We won't have any mercy when facing the Coyotes. Gary Bettman, not a Jet, but guess who was the great Mr. Dave Ash. Winnipeg loves its hockey, we wish it would have stayed, cause here Bobby Hall is a legend, but so is Dancing Gary. Scott Arneal had a Winnipeg Jet mullet. Randy Carlisle always refused to wear a helmet. He sometimes gets snow and others may have grass, but Jim Kite could have kicked Sedano Chara's ass.
Yes!
That's allowed?
That's allowed.
Put on your jersey, it's time for NHL hockey. We won't have any mercy when facing the Coyotes. Chris King was our captain, Bob Essence our goalie. This is so stupid. The queen hung from the rafters back in Winnipeg Jet glory. We want our Jets back, but many people said no. But even while watching baseball, we yelled, go Jets, go. We may not have had the best arena for the Jets to be in, but we had a trough for all Winnipeg Jet fans to pee in.
Yes!
Dale Howard Chuck always made us the proudest, and Don Cherry still says Winnipeg crowds are the loudest. So put on your jersey, it's time for NHL hockey. We won't have any mercy when facing the Coyotes. We'll fill the stands and party, even when it's minus 40. We really didn't want to beg, but welcome back to Winnipeg.
On YouTube, welcome back Winnipeg Jets, Rob Nash with 2Bs.com for more information. Thank you for coming in and doing that live. That is absolutely awesome, Rob.
Fantastic.
3:27, we'll be back after this.
Awesome.
Awesome. Nice, man. That is great. That is great.
It's like a GPS, but with way better music. The Backseat Drive with Shadow Davis on 92 City FM.